What's strange happening on Pluto? Pluto was considered the ninth planet in the solar system for a long time. However, today it is no longer so. Despite that, it has not ceased to attract the attention of astronomers, as it is the largest celestial body in the Kuiper belt, a region beyond the orbit of Neptune. After nearly a century of discovery, in July 2013, NASA's New Horizons probe sent the first sharp images of the dwarf planet Pluto. Although at first these images did not have too many details, little by little scientists have revealed the secrets of the dwarf planet and have discovered that extraordinary things are happening on Pluto. Ice volcanoes. The first thing that jumped out at you was the sharpness with which the surface of Pluto was photographed. In the images sent by the New Horizons probe, this dwarf planet shows a white surface. But if we see it in much more detail, we find peaks of what seem to be mountains. After much analysis, it has been concluded that these peaks are cryovolcanoes. A cryovolcano is an ice volcano. As you heard, while on Earth we have lava volcanoes, there are ice volcanoes on Pluto. But don't get too excited. In reality, this has been seen in other bodies of the solar system. In the moon of Saturn, Enceladus, this type of cryovolcano has also been observed. The strange thing here is that volcanism can only arise if there is a heat source driving the eruptions. On Earth, volcanic eruptions are caused by the radioactive decay of the planet's core. A volcanic eruption occurs when lava and accumulated gases are ejected by the pressure of the Earth's internal heat. Another way volcanic eruptions can occur is by gravitational pulling caused by another larger body. For example, Jupiter's satellite Io is the object in the solar system with the highest volcanic activity, because Jupiter's gravitational pulls cause an immense tidal force in the satellite's core, which eventually produces volcanic eruptions. But what happens on Pluto? Pluto does not have accumulated heat in its core like the Earth, or that is what was believed, nor does it suffer from gravitational pulls by any of its moon. So what produces the eruptions on Pluto? The only explanation scientists have come up with is that the heat produced by the eruptions on Pluto could come from within. Some bodies in the solar system, such as Europa or Enceladus, could also have this type of ocean, which remains in a liquid state. Remember that we mentioned that in the Enceladus satellite there is also cryovolcanism. Cryovolcanoes are not necessarily formed by high temperatures, but by considerable temperature differences. In this case, the low temperature of the ice with the water's high temperatures, just over 0 degrees Celsius, causes ice volcanism. In this type of cold volcanism, liquid water plays the role of magma or lava, while ice plays the role of rock. This is precisely what could be producing the cryovolcanic eruptions of Pluto. So the dwarf planet would not be cold and still as we thought, but would be a body with a lot of activity inside. No impact craters. Another intriguing mystery from the images obtained by the New Horizons probe is that, unlike other distant celestial bodies, on Pluto there are almost no signs of asteroid impacts. This does not mean that asteroid impacts do not occur on Pluto, but that something is covering them. For example, on Earth, asteroid impacts are almost not appreciated, unlike the Moon, which has thousands of impact craters. This is because on Earth, erosion covers the craters and leaves no trace of them over time. While on the Moon, there is no atmosphere, no tectonic movements. The craters remain eternally. If Pluto has few impact craters, it means that something is covering it, and that could be cryovolcanic eruptions. This would mean that Pluto would exhibit more significant activity than any other bodies in the solar system, even more than Mercury. This is genuinely fascinating, considering it is a small, cold, distant celestial body. If you're liking this video, let us know by leaving a like, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and don't forget to ring the notification bell so you don't miss any of our videos. Recent activity. Thanks to the images taken by the New Horizons probe, scientists have observed strange lumps that had never been observed in the solar system. This indicates that there were active ice volcanoes on Pluto that could reach up to 7 kilometers in height. To give you an idea, Pluto's diameter is 1/6 that of the Earth. Volcanoes so high in such a small celestial body are something that has never been seen before. It is as if we have a volcano 5 times higher than Mount Everest on Earth. Images taken by NASA have allowed a team led by the Southwest Research Institute in Colorado to examine an area dominated by significant irregular elevations southwest of an area called Sputnik Planitia, the icy plain near the dwarf planet's equator. The team writes that no similar features exist anywhere else in the solar system and has analyzed geomorphology and composition to conclude that the region was created by cryovolcanic processes, which are now unique to Pluto. According to the analysis, Pluto's interior temperature has remained higher than previously thought for long enough to allow for that phenomenon. Instead of spewing lava, cryovolcanoes eject a thick, muddy mixture of water and ice, or perhaps even a solid flow like Earth's glaciers. Planetary scientist Kelsey Singer of the Southwest Research Institute in Colorado explained. On this dwarf planet, areas of huge ice volcanoes with a remarkable texture of undulating relief can be observed. It's hard to date the formation of these volcanoes accurately, but we think they may be a few hundred million years old or even younger, Singer said. Since the region in which these formations are located lacks impact craters caused by asteroids, they do not rule out the possibility that ice volcanoes continue to form there today. Consider that the New Horizons spacecraft only approached Pluto once, and we have made all these great discoveries. But to know if these events continue to occur, the only way is to send a new mission to Pluto, which will go to photograph the planet, so that we can see if new volcanoes have formed. If so, an incredible possibility would have to be contemplated. Could there be water on Pluto? Think about the following. A small body like Pluto, which should have lost most of its internal heat long ago, managed to retain enough energy to fuel extensive geological activity unique in its kind. The researchers analyzed photographs of a region dominated by two large mounds, Wright Mons and Picard Mons, which scientists believe are cryovolcanoes. Wright Mons is a mountain 4 to 5 kilometers high and approximately 150 kilometers wide, while Picard Mons is approximately 7 kilometers high and 250 kilometers wide. The suspected ice volcanoes also have intense depressions at their peaks. Many parts of the area also have an unusual appearance, full of lumps or mounds formed by wavy and rounded mounds. The researchers believe that smaller mounds made up of ice volcanoes could have accumulated over time to form these two central mounds, which would indicate that cryovolcano activity would be expected on Pluto. There are no other areas on Pluto that resemble this region. These features look very different from any volcano in the solar system, whether they are icy examples or rocky volcanoes. They form like mountains, but there is no caldera at the top, and they have large bumps everywhere. Something unique. Under this strong evidence of cryovolcanic activity on Pluto, there is a slight possibility that liquid water is inside the dwarf planet and in other solar system bodies such as Europa or Enceladus. Although Pluto is located in one of the coldest areas of the solar system, it has some conditions that could make it possible for water to exist beneath its ice sheets. This water would not be in the form of a vast ocean like the one thought beneath Jupiter's moon Europa, but instead would be found in small spaces beneath some regions of the dwarf planet. The internal heat trapped inside could cause temperature differences between water and ice, and this would cause cryovolcanism. Everything fits perfectly. Or not. The truth is that not entirely. Although this is a possibility, we do not have enough data to corroborate if cryovolcanism is still active on Pluto. On the contrary, the images show that if there are ice eruptions, these occurred millions of years ago. Although on astronomical timescales, a million years is not much, we cannot claim that such activity is still occurring on Pluto today. The only way to have these questions answered is to resend a scout ship. But since we imagine possible scenarios with our information, what if we go one step further? Could there be life on Pluto? If there were to be liquid water beneath Pluto's thick ice sheets, it wouldn't be far-fetched if there could even be living things. Remember that water is one of the most indispensable requirements for living beings on a planet or celestial body. Where there is water, there is life. Unfortunately, all these are theories, and it is impossible to say with total certainty that there is liquid water on Pluto, much less living beings, but it's worth dreaming. So far, all we know about Pluto is thanks to the few images and information sent to us by the New Horizons probe. We still have a lot to learn about this dwarf planet so far away. What do you think? Do you think there could be liquid water or even living beings on Pluto? Let us know your opinion with your valuable comment.